top of him. So the waveform plus adaptive strike, and then they just throw a Mystic Flare on it.
I mean, that's the dream, right?
Right? I mean, wow. Look at that cohort.
Oh, my God.
I mean, at least it's better than zero.
Hey! So, and the kill participation, you know, he's got that.
Well, look at that.
Pretty good damage, and that's 17k damage.
Yeah,
that's
in the one game he won. In the one game he won, it was great.
I mean,
guys, don't lose hope, guys. Wings picked it, so, you know, something's going up.
I'm not discrediting that. I think this is amazing, and they're going to probably win because they're doing something Wingsy.
What else does it give, though? You have the instant cast silence for the Slardar, though. So if you do have vision of him, and he's trying to get, like, blinking, you can get the silence off. There is
but
that.
It's just mostly telling me that the morphing is like a stun morphing. That's,
yeah.
That's what I'm getting right now. Because they have... Sanking is also really good with the Skyruff. So they basically have a lot of setup and low cooldown damage.
Yeah.
Skyruff Optimal is very low cooldown, so you can keep doing it.
You know what I saw last time I saw a stun morphling that was absolutely disgusting was an Elder Titan. My God.
I think it's good with damage, though. You don't want to keep disabling the hero if you can't kill him. Uh-huh. So you want to have heroes that, like, Ursa RPA, you stun and then you kill. Or even, like, Sniper, someone that has a high burst damage.
Absolutely.
So Crystal Maiden by Liquid.
Aura. Oh, okay.
There you go. As you said, high burst damage.
Oh gosh, this morphling is looking like
it's a support, right?
No, off lane. I think.
Oh yeah, Sanking support then. Yeah.
Yeah, it's still possible.
Yeah.
It's what looking
is,
like that.
What is the thought behind the Crystal Maiden?
It could be setting up for a hero that like it's a strong support, and it could be setting up for a hero that needs a lot of mana.
He's a brute as well versus morphling. You can't waveform.
Oh yeah, that's a good point against morphling. Yeah.
And versus Sanking, you can't cast anything in the root too.
It's just a good support now because of the root. No thanks to the root. Pick CM slacks. Don't pick.
So they have long druid root, CM root, very good versus Sanking and morphling.
Dare I say we might be seeing the Storm Spirit coming out of this game? Mm. Mana regen provided by Crystal Maiden. Great way to catch up.
Daxia Storm, right? That was what? Who picked that yesterday?
Yesterday, someone.
Centaur. Yeah. Get to the back lines. Get
OG,
on top of the sniper.
OG did that. Actually.
Oh, OG did that, yeah. So they're going to have the Centaur to, you know, just run around, jump the sky off, jump the sniper, yeah.
Another old sniper versus new sniper.
Yeah.
This time I'm having a bit more faith in the old sniper, I think.
Why?
Because Wings, and I feel like they got this plan.
Liquid has like they have these two tanky frontliners though already, like Slardar, Centaur for the Lone Druid, while Sniper has, I mean, potentially a Morphling.
Strength
Morphling, but...
Okay.
And run in front of him, Strength Morphling,
and he would be the
please.
Tank, in a way, right now, at least from what we see.
Basically, the Sniper needs like a Chronosphere now, I think. Chrono would be nice. Chrono with Skyruff.
Works very well.
Chrono with Epicenter.
Yeah,
Safe lane Void. Offlane morphing?
That could be decent.
I actually like that idea.
Cool.
I like what you're thinking.
You chrono and there's no use of the stampede. Can't get out of that. So that's
nice. That actually sounds sick. You sold me.
Nice.
Nice.
Sold me.
Dude, they banned Ember.
This is your chance.
Ember is pretty good against Void.
That's another root.
Gotta ban out the Void, Liquid. Save yourselves. Winter's perfect call here. Oh no.
Safe lane Void call.
Yeah, they do run safe lane Void. I remember Shadow played. He played Lincoln's Void. I remember back then. He was the first guy who did that.
And that would allow them to run the weird lanes that we're kind of talking about.
It is still a lone druid though. I kind of feel like Matuma Man lone druid will still be really really strong. And it seems.
And then Ogre.
They are expecting still a support to be picked up rather than a core.
Yeah, some like beefy frontliner enable his sniper.
Yeah. Yeah. Nobody wants to face off against Bloodbusted.
That's what they think. But Wings is like Ogre.
So Liquid needs a mid hero. Usually only Matuma Man plays the lone druid, right?
Yeah. I wouldn't say only. I've definitely seen Miracle played in mid too.
But
it
would be normally Matuma Man.
Yeah.
So it's still open, technically. Between
technically,
the two
players. Yes. What are you thinking? What are you looking?
Not sure though. They can pick so many different heroes. Like someone to use corrosive haze. Gosh, I need to get used to that. Yeah, Slug is really good against Morphling.
And Slug is a Matuma Man hero.
And Slug is also very good against the Strength Morph because you can Dark Pack the stun.
And you get a lot of stats
good
in
against,
the fight.
Good against Sniper as well.
Yeah, you can get a lot of stats
That's a good pick.
In the
very,
fight.
Very good pick.
When we saw Resolution play Slug, Matuma Man was in the lounge and he was literally saying, I'm not a great Slug anymore. What happened? I'm not a great Slark anymore.
Well, You know, maybe...
He said that multiple times.
Maybe he was just being kind. Maybe he thinks that he's a good enough Slark to beat Wings where DC could have...
He actually told it to Blitz as well, and Blitz is DC.
Oh, you
so
see?
So perhaps he was just, you know, thinking, we're not picking Slark ever. We're not picking Slark ever, I swear.
Gosh, you're just ignoring them.
Winter is just...
No, I'm trying to think. No, I'm trying to think.
Our analysts are thinking.
I'm looking for heroes that more like damage to deal with the Slark, like inside when if he does get the Shadow Dance. They have Sand King and like Waveform and like Skyrath.
It's that big team, but if they don't win the lanes, they're going to be in trouble.
Yeah, but it's good versus the Centaur, Slardar, and Slark. But yeah.
But the Root.
And they do have, yeah, they do have a lot of Root.
The Root is going to own him. I don't know. CM is really good against Timber.
It is.
In my opinion. You just root him, cast your ulti. Bye bye, Timber.
Okay, I was just curious here.
It was pretty good against Slark. Faceless Void. What a great...
Yeah, that's true. I mean, easy catch. That's true, Jake.
Easy catch.
I was already sold on this Void, dude.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think of other things.
Oh!
Yeah, it's offlane morphing,
right?
Or support morphing, either way.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's one of the two.
Yeah,
okay.
One of the two.
So CK versus Lone Druid Slark. Phantasm seems pretty good there.
You guys don't really make have a stuff prediction? To clear it.
Yeah, they actually don't have like instant clear for the Phantasm. Good point.
Mm.
I'm gonna just go with Wingstone and like.
All right.
I like Skyrath. I like the CK pick. They don't have much to clear the Phantasm, so I'll try it.
Sorry, Drow. I'm taking Liquid.
Hey, whoa!
Flip-flopper, you just
flip flopper. What a flip flopper!
I'm just being rational.
I gotta go with Liquid as well. I've seen Matumbo do some incredible things on a Slark before. I'm probably gonna see it again this game.
I'm gonna believe in the plan that Wings seems to have. So it's a 50-50 here on the panel. That is it from us. We are heading over to Lyrical and Gods for the game one of this series. 5 seconds.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Hello and welcome. We're here for the final series of the day. God. Liquid facing off against Wings. One of the most anticipated.
But that was with like an invoke. The Slark is gonna have a good time this game, I feel, against a lot of these heroes. Doesn't deal great with the Chaos Knight, perhaps, but I feel like all in all, I'm kind of siding a bit more with Winter, and that I'm liking what Liquid have done with their draft.
Yeah, it's looking like it's definitely well rounded, and they're gonna be prepared for it. You know, I'm also taking a look at this and just sort of seeing the combination. You were mentioning earlier that you felt like one of the natural combos with this draft is the long duration stun into a Mystic Flare from Skywrath Mage, and a lot of these heroes are very susceptible to that. It feels like potentially, you know, a CM, you get caught in that, you're gonna go down really quickly. Even a Slark, if he doesn't get hit by that Dark Pack at the right time, would be a problem.
Yeah, it's definitely what Wings are going to look to kind of capitalize on. They're going to be looking for those pickoffs constantly. Slark's going to have to be very ready and on the finger with that Dark Pack. He has to make sure he gets it off on that Morphling stun. And I think this is something Wings have probably theorycrafted that may work well against the Lone Druid, because typically Lone Druid's in range form. He's very squishy but hard to get to. Morphling with the stun, it's a pretty long cast range. You can get something like an Aether Lens if he really wants to. Same for the Mystic Flare, long cast range. You can actually burst down a Lone Druid, and at that point, like, you can't really do anything when you're stunned.
Yeah.
You can't stop that burst damage coming out. So, in theory, this can work very well for Wings. We'll have to see how, in practice, it can work, because they have to get to that point. They have to do okay in the lanes. Right now, it looks like Liquid with the CM pick, a four-position slider. They've got pretty solid lanes all in all. And they can put some pressure on the sniper early if they want to try and roam, gank his lane a bit. So we'll see how things actually go in that early game.
Yeah, and the other thing to keep in mind here as well is that level 25, if we ever get to that point for a Morphling, it is Ice who's playing it, the long duration waveform, closer ability to get in there on top of somebody else. So a lot of interesting little dynamics as we do have this short little pause before we hop into the game. I want to make sure all the things are working well for everybody.
I love your optimism. You're like, short little pause. It's pause. Like, this could be a 30-minute pause game.
Well, you got to dream, right?
You can tell whose first land it is.
Exactly, that's right. Yes. I'm the guy sure who's it's all going to be fine.
Short pause, small technical issue. We'll be resumed in 2 minutes, guys.
Look at them. They look happy as clams. It's, it's going to be fine there.
I'm like, look, I've been to lands before in China, you know. This could be a four-hour wait. If this was the Shanghai Major, we'd be waiting till tomorrow. Yeah. Luckily, it's Starladder, and they're amazing, so we won't be waiting till tomorrow. It probably will be a short pause, but...
Damn, that's good, yeah. And, you know, I want to talk a little bit more about the draft here, just because, to me at least, when I'm looking at these two teams, it feels like order versus chaos, really, is what we've got. Mm-hmm. Like, Liquid, just a very clean and cohesive team that feel like they always play together in like a very well-defined way. Go to each of the towers, take them down, and then move to the next set. Whereas Wings, it's just chaos, but it's ordered chaos. And I think that that's such a cool thing to see go up against each other.
Every now and then the chaos get out of hand, and that's when Wings beat, quote-unquote, beat themselves, something the panel kind of mentioned. But yeah, we'll see how Liquid can handle that chaotic factor of the Wings draft and whether or not just their general discipline is going to be enough. Kuro, one of the probably most disciplined and kind of, I guess, strategic captains out there. You can always see a very clear game plan. He's very like active in controlling the team, leading around that. Even from a caster's perspective, you often see him drawing lines on the map, saying, giving his team clear direction where they want to push, where they're going to take their next objective. So that's going to be no different here against a team like Wings, and even more important here against a team like Wings.
You know, and I was a little bit concerned about GH going into this tournament. I was like, how well is he going to perform? You know, still relatively new with the team, a little bit of a newer-ish player as well. He has just blown the socks off of this one. He's been playing an immaculate game so far. Been really impressed. He's just like a happy guy to see walking around. He's smiling everywhere in the player room. It was a great way to see that first.
Yeah, very, very lovely, humble guy. So he's going to be on that four position slot. I think he's played already this tournament and going to be a nice partner to have in the Crystal Maiden. Very, a hero that, I mean, not that going to have major mana problems, but just being able to use that crush a bit more freely does give you a bit more freedom when you are roaming around with Tranquil Boots. So you've got the HP sustained from the Tranquils, then you get the mana sustained from the CM aura as well.
Oh.
By the way, Iceice with the Morphling has Iron Talon level 1, so we're going to be seeing full Adji. It ain't no strength yet, for now. This is like a for now kind of thing. I feel like he's going to just be jungling it up, and then eventually we'll go that strength stun Morphling. You're not picking this offlane slash jungle Morphling to be a carry. You're just picking the Iron Talon Adji for now to jungle faster.
I remember there was a period of time in the last patch where in NA they were running consistently a Morphling, not in the four position, but they would pick up Helm of the Dominator and just go full Adji and then lifesteal off of it. And it's something where we could maybe see him pick up some type of lifesteal early on and stay in there. Do you expect him to get active earlier?
Yeah, I'd say a bit active. I think this is going to be more like what we saw out of the Pylodite Io with the Iron Talon, where it's like you jungle, you get your fast level 3, and then you roam and start getting a bit more active from there. But yeah, for now he is full Iron Talon jungling. Has this really nice little ledge spot. Maybe the Observer will switch over to soon enough. But for now, we'll keep an eye on the mid lane. But yeah, this is not going to be like I don't think we'll see lifesteal jungle mode. That's something way too common in pubs. Like that full position player is like, man, I don't want to play support. I want to go jungle. Legion Commander spam. What do I do? Morphling, Iron Talon, Adji. Get a Mask of Madness. I don't think we'll see that.
All right. Well,
Iceice is a team player.
That's probably to the benefit of everybody's pubs across the world. And, well, it does look like we're also going to be getting some jungling coming out from Mind Control. Heads off there to the side as well. And in the mid lane, it's just the sniper versus sniper matchup. Matumbo Man versus the sniper.
Yeah.
Continue to be pretty even there.
Yep.
It doesn't feel like there's a whole lot of necessary movement around the map. Everybody's trying to get their levels.
Kuro's not a four position player, but both teams effectively jungling one of their supports, so Kuro gets the early aura for the team. Morphling, well, gets a fast level 2 for the team. That's really all he's done. He's not going to offer a whole lot for now, but it does feel like greed is the name of the game for this laning stage. GH has just been able to poke and prod here and there. He's going to probably go look for some bounty runes to snipe. Yeah, he'll take the enemy bounty rune. This is like one of those early games where you, unless you're, okay, so CM is going to come out of the jungle. Unless you see that early active CM, the Slaughter doesn't really have great gank opportunities. But the CM has made a move towards his mid lane with Slaughter.
This could be a little bit tough. There's going to be a lot of damage there, but not a ton of heroes who can make the rotation to actually save Blink here in the mid lane. It's going to throw out the trap, and Olde end up getting the stun, and he is just gone too quickly for them to do anything at all. The Skywrath Mage is going to come in, throw out a couple stuns on GH, bit of damage, but nothing else of it.
Great use of the Illusion Rune. Not normally a particularly useful rune to get early on. You're normally thinking, oh, regen to help heal you up, DD to help CS in lane, but the Illusion Rune to tank the tower there, tank two, maybe three tower shots, and just that in itself meant that casualties were not going to happen from the Liquid three-man dive squad.
Well, and it does feel to me at least a little bit as if Sniper getting out of control is not the biggest plan with this Wings draft. It's much more about getting that Morphling online and making moves around the map with it, which they're still accomplishing with their draft despite that gank.
Yeah, Sniper can get levels, you're still okay. He can just do damage through Shrapnel and Assassinate. And he's still getting okay-ish farm, has 11 CS to the Lone Druid's 12. Now they're even on CS, so it's not like he's losing this lane in CS, although that kill does give the edge towards Liquid. The kill was picked up by GH's Slada, which, again, doesn't really... It actually helps GH a lot. He's going to get some fast items off of that, so we'll see where he looks to go with that.
Well, right back in, apparently, is going to be the call as they're setting up again onto Blink in the mid lane. The smoke used this time, and well, they are going to have to sprint up again in a little bit.
I feel like this is where you should be... They're holding their scam, which I feel like isn't something you want to do when your mid lane is in an exposed position. Top lane, it's going to be a TP into the shrine.
Oh, yeah.
Punish the aggression of Skywrath.
Oh, a pretty quick and easy one there. Mind Control just picks it up with the double edge. Is not a great way to stop it. It does look like the rotation is now going to come down towards the bottom. So Slark, on top of Faith Beyond, can't go for the pounce if he wants. A little bit of a pause.
He doesn't see GH yet, I believe. GH is pretty far back, and it is nighttime, so I believe he's... Yeah, GH is in fog, so he has no idea Slada's coming. And hasn't seen a pounce animation yet, so Faith Beyond probably just thinks Miracle's just playing a bit aggressive, trying to get some essence shift here. He may not expect the Slaughter to backstab him.
He did end up pinging out the area, but obviously the vision was that. All right, come on now. We're in the game back again, and Faith Beyond able to get the Burrow Strike to back out and away. GH gets the crush as well, Dark Pack, and then they get the kill.
Guy comes down, but it's too late. Damage has been done. Looks like Slada, yeah, making use. They tried to smoke the mid lane, but once they realize the Blink Sniper's kind of playing a bit defensively, they're not going to get on top of him. And a kill, a free kill is there on the Skywrath at that top shrine. They take that with the CM. Slada rotates bottom, so they end up getting two kills off of that smoke, even if it wasn't the intended kill. It is still a nice boost to Liquid's early game. Crow will ward the mid high ground, but that gets spotted, so should be easy D-ward.
Yeah. And we'll see if they're going to end up hopping over there and getting it. In the meantime, you take a look at the CS battle. CK getting a little bit of the better end of the exchange, but getting dove very hard here in the mid lane. Wait, a good adaptive strike to at least back away GH for the moment. So they are going to be able to get this kill onto the bear, and they sweep up smoke for the game.
No, CK TP, though, so win for Liquid. CK TP's in. Spento gets some free alone time. CK will miss some farm off that. And they're going to kill a bottom lane. Faith Beyond, again, just slightly overstepping his boundaries against this Miracle Slark, who now hits level 6.
Well, it sounds like we might have lost audio for just a second, but we'll continue as if we did not. And it looks like mid lane again going there onto the sniper, able to find him. And, well, the turnaround kill, Matumbo Man is going to end up going down. Kuroki just going to back out for the moment, does not want to get taken down. So 6 minutes in, and you found 5 kills at this point for Liquid. One is only there on the table for Wings. And it feels like this early game is going everything their way. I can't really think about, you know, any lane that's not working out for them. At the exception, I guess the only thing is that Ice Ice, has had himself a good time.
He's winning
the jungle. Right, exactly.
Yeah. Chaos Knight, I guess, still farming, but the fact that the safe lane Chaos Knight is doing this well, TP's mid and doesn't get anything is like, okay, is he really doing that well when he's making that first rotation and not getting anything out of it? So, not quite what you'd hope for.
Well, again, down here in the bottom lane, Slark, they've basically forced out the SK at this point, and he's been forced to run back over into his own jungle. Does have, at least for the moment now, the poor man's shield as well as boots, and looks like they're thinking about coming in and contesting him. GH on the chase. Faith Beyond in a lot of trouble. He's going to walk right in. to crush. Hoof stomp to follow, and that's a curb stomp on Faceon.
Yep, the 2016 Rookie of the Year is off to a rough start here. 0-3 on the Sand King. He is being punished time and time again by first the Miracle Slark, now a new ganking duo has found him. So yeah, all lanes looking pretty good for Liquid at this point. The rotations continue to be effective. Kuro as well as GH both finding great effect early on. And GH is 700 gold with Tranquils. He's going to have a pretty fast blink at this rate. This is a lot of gold for a full position slaughter to have this early on. So if he can find another kill on this sniper, Liquid are going to be in a fantastic spot.
Yeah, I mean, this is also in a position now where you have Matumbo Man, who's got off to a great start as well. So he's going to have that damage to back him up. And, well, GH maybe getting a little bit frisky over there to the side with Flank. Does end up backing out after he's spotted. And, well, they'll just be able to stop the aggression from there.
Yeah, Sniper just trying to push him back with the shrapnel. Does use up one of those three charges, but wanting to make sure his tower doesn't take too much damage at this stage of the game. Looks like Wings are going to go and fall back into kind of a farming style. They're going to build up towards an Midas onto Shadow's Chaos Knight. So he's going to kind of itemize a bit more for the late game and kind of deciding that Wings are not really able to match up right now. And they're just going to probably go a bit greedier. So probably see them look to make some like smoke ganks in place off of the Skywrath level 6. That's where they get a good damage output to kind of air with the Morphling or someone like a Sand King Burrow Strike, but even when they have that kind of ganking joke, CK is still going to just want to be farming, so they want to make sure at least one of their cores is going to scale well to the late game.
Yeah, I mean, in spite of the fact that we've been talking about Ice Ice basically having the jungle to himself, you take a look at it, and Slaughter's actually ahead of him in terms of net worth. They've got four heroes in basically the top six at this stage. It's really looking quite good for Liquid, and with the double Blink Dagger initiators that are going to be coming out as well, it's going to be quite difficult to deal with.
Yeah. Well, see what the next move is going to be. As things stand, GH is still lurking around this middle lane, seeing if he can catch maybe any of those greedy junglers or perhaps make another swoop on this mid lane. But Ice Ice is already in position, sitting behind, protecting Blink Sniper. I think they've recognized that his sniper is a common prey, this Liquid squad.
I mean, the crazy thing about it, though, is that he's still sitting up there fairly high in net worth. Like, he's 800 gold behind he's only 200 gold behind the lone druid right now. He's having himself a good time.
Yeah, the biggest scare is perhaps Miracle Slark and how well he's doing. He's going to hit a very fast Shadow Blade. He's going for the fighting item. So while Chaos Knight's like, oh, I'm going to go a bit greedy, get this Midas, play the late game, Miracle's going to hit this Shadow Blade around perhaps 12, 13 minutes and start getting very active. He's a very good hero to gank a sniper with, can put a lot of pressure on, so Miracle is going to be having a potentially very good game once he picks up that item.
Well, Smoke immediately running into GH. He is going to be taking a hell of a lot of damage. Silence there as well, and that is going to be the kill, but probably not the person that they wanted to find with that one.
Probably not. It's still a kill, gets Skywrath very close to the level 6, so not a complete disaster, but yeah, they were much more likely looking for Matu on the lone druid. They still are looking for him there. Grouping up with three here. Faith Beyond in the trees could find a Burrow Strike potentially. Doesn't have a good way to cut much further in, and until that Sky gets level 6, I'm not sure if that's going to be a potential, actual viable kill for them.
I mean, he's actually pretty far forward now, and they do have Epicenter going to channel it now. Faith Beyond, actually, no, he doesn't end up going for it. They're going to get the Savage Roar off,
there's
but Blink will be able to find the Assassinate. He is still going to be able to escape, though. So, no luck on that kill.
GBH, is he going to pay for this with his life with the sprint wearing off? I think he may actually go down one more prop.
Oh, no. God, another Burrow Strike. They turn it back, though, and Kuro's going to go down for it. Mind control. I mean, they're sort of saving each other, but putting themselves in danger as well. They are going to be able to find that vision. And mind control, looking for the stomp, not going to happen. They bring back in GH, and, well, also with Slark here as well, trying to find that kill. They're not going to get it. GH will find that crush. Morphin is showing up now as well, trying to find himself one. Can they do it? Burrow, they connect. Very nicely played. The follow-up Mystic Flare is there, but it's not enough to find any type of kill, and Slark will be able to back out. But a very chaotic couple of seconds there in the lane.
Faith coming up big there. There's some offlaners that you're like, they go to a 0-3 side, and you're like, okay, this guy's not going to be doing much until he farms, catches up, gets a Blink Dagger. Faith Beyond, 0-3 Sand King, smokes up with his team, gets his team a kill, roams mid, gets another couple of kills, and suddenly he's saving his sniper from a Slark rotation as well. That was a couple of really big plays from him in succession, and that is exactly what you want to see out of your Sand King after he goes 0-3. Very impactful play out of Faith Beyond.
it did sort of show one side of this, at least, which is the Mystic Flare not doing enough damage to Slark when he's within that ulti. And I think that they're going to need some more damage types throughout the course of this game.
But like a almost pseudo-defensive Mystic Flare in some ways. It was like, oh god, our sniper's going to die. Let's just throw damage at the Slark to scare him back. And it kind of accomplished that, I guess. But low cooldown ultimate in the Mystic Flare. So 60 seconds means it's already back up. They're already smoking towards mid lane. Wings want to strike again. They want to find Matu.
This could be a pretty big one if they're able to get it. He is going to show now in the mid lane. Several heroes in the area. They're going to walk forward. CK gets the Reality Rip pullback. The Tumble Man, sudden, and well, he just goes down. No need for the Mystic Flare there.
Yeah. Why not hold it if you can? And he's ready to find a follow-up pickoff if possible. Wolfling even rotating in on this one. So with 5 mid lane, Wings are poised to take a T1, but it is a bit of a trade with perhaps Mind Control getting some damage down the top. So not necessarily a free uncontested one, but Phantasm from Shadow means they want to make sure they secure and guarantee this one.
The Midas, you know, CK at 12 minutes grouping up as 5 with his team in the mid lane and taking the tower.
Yes. He's pretty high level, not as high as the Slark, but this Midas will guarantee that he kind of keeps up in farm with Slark and also experience. So even if Slark's getting kills and stuff, the CK just using that Midas on a couple big neutrals here and there is more or less equal to the Slark at this point.
We'll have to watch how this evolves throughout the game. The Shadow hit from Slark is going to be coming out fairly soon for him. Is only a little bit away from it.
A little bit. It would have been faster if he, that TP mid where he went for the sniper, if he was successful, he'd have it by now. Or if it stayed bottom to keep farming, he'd have it by now. So he makes a bit of an investment going for that, and it doesn't pay off.
It does sort of feel a little bit, though, like if Wings stick to this group-up style, the Shadow Blade, it might not be able to do as much as you want. But look at this play that they're making. They're in towards Roshan and trying to take it down at this early point in the game.
That is a bold, bold call. There's a lot of Wings here. They're backing out. Wings are not coming, but they also don't see Wings. But now they will. They'll see Shadow as well as Blink mid, and with this, they may look to poke their head back into Roche. Yeah, it looks like GH will start reamping it up, and they'll be good to go. Roche for a tier 1. This is a very favorable trade for Liquid at this stage. And then something that... I wonder if Slark's going to come over and pick this up, or if they're going to just give it to Matu. Looks like they may just keep it on Matu's blowing through it. With the Maelstrom coming online soon, he is going to be somewhat teamfight ready.
You'd think the Wings have an idea that something's going on right now, but they will know for sure as Roshan does finally fall, and maybe even going to be able to come on back down and take the defending the tier 2 tower.
Wings already kind of set up. If they want to do that, yeah, they're going to have to start rotating down here fast. Problem is, Shadow has another Phantasm, and he's, even with just Treads, Midas is very strong and scary. So it does look like they're going to give this one up, do some damage at mid. Matu looking for the trade there, and Wings looking to TP back and set up.
Oh yeah, a lot of them in the area right now, and they throw out the stun, Ice, connects, and they are going to be able to take down the bear. So not a bad little pickup there for them, as Faith Beyond is going to blink out in a way before the rotation comes up from the rest of Liquid.
I wonder if that was spotted. It looked like he may have been inside of the creeps there, so perhaps Liquid will be a bit apprehensive about going for this top tier 1, knowing that the Sand King is lurking around. They're ideally looking for that pickoff on Miracle first to make it a bit safer. He's roaming around with that Shadow Blade, but we are at that stage of the game where Wings will look to 5-man around the Phantasm. Even with CK having a lot of money and he could pick up a new big item soon, Sniper's really a hero you can't be just all solo farming with.
Oh, that's a pretty quick and easy jump there. They find Y, and no way out for him. Faith Beyond a little bit off the mark with the stun. Now turning on a Slardar. It's the very long duration. Pull him back in, and that is going to be the kill, in spite of the stun that comes out from GH.
I mean, initially it looked like they weren't going to have damage to kill the Slardar with just the Wolf Stun with no Skywrath, but then Shadow shows up, and he's like, oh, don't worry, guys. I've got a Chaos Bolt, Reality Rip. I can pack a punch, and sure enough, they do get that kill in return. So Skywrath for Slardar. Definitely a good trade, considering Slardar was very close to his Blink Dagger. He was only a couple hundred gold away from that one. And Wings are perhaps poised to find more here. Liquid are hiding in the trees, but
Mind Control?
That was not the Blink he was hoping for.
No, they found him, and they are going to be able to take him down as well. The question is Bro going to be able to get out as well? He does. He actually cast his Q as well, trying to TP out. They aren't going to find him. So Kuro at least gets out from that one.
I guess the GH kill, though. A bigger kill than getting Kuro. That's another kill on Slardar. He just wants his Blink Dagger, and he's died 2 times in a row. While Phantasm gets popped, that means this is going to be a T1, possibly even a T2 tower here. Miracle's in the neighborhood, but not easy to engage into this. You perhaps kill something like a support here. You can get some essence shift on a morphling. Not sure that's really the play. Ideally, you just try and kill the Skywrath and then get out, but that was a good sequence of events for the Chinese squad.
It feels right now like you want to be able to find those pickoffs, like you're saying, but with this group-up style that we're seeing from Wings, it's really hard to punish it. And I'm kind of wondering, what's the plan B right now for Liquid? How do you deal with all of this pressure?
It's really playing around the Blink Dagger timer, and they've got the Central Blink, so perhaps they could have used that to smoke with, but now that they've kind of just settled down, gone to the farm, Slark's finished the Shadow Blade, it feels like they want to have that Slaughter Blink as well, so they can get that quick burst damage from the Blink stun with the Amp damage, but Blue Druid very strong. Like, they got this Aegis, and they've just given up kills. They haven't fought around the Aegis. That's where I felt like the Slark Aegis may have been the better candidate, just because Miracle's the one who's much more in your face and going to be able to do a lot more damage than the Lone Druid as far as going onto the front line. So he gets a lot more value out of an Aegis. But the fact they give it to Matu suggests Liquid's idea and their game plan is to kind of, let's farm. Let's use this as a farming Aegis. We don't really want to fight Wings. It didn't really feel like they were trying to fight Wings at top. They just got picked off a little bit by the rotation, and then they were in the trees just waiting to see what happened, to see if they could catch some stragglers, and got found out as well. So Wings just seem to be catching him by surprise.
They're so close right now. They found GH. Yeah. He's only 75 gold away from his Blink Dagger. He is going to... Oh, my God. Alive on 58. Okay. He's really close. They're able to turn it back around now. Take down Faith Beyond. And, well, he actually did end up dying to the Caustic Proc there. So he doesn't end up getting his Blink Dagger. The BKB already popped for it. But they're able to get the Entangle. Shadow now in some trouble as well. Can they take him down before he gets out? They are going to be able to find that kill. Liquid coming back in a big way. And it looks like that's going to be the extent of their kills.
That's a 10-second BKB from Chaos Knight as well. Interesting to see him go straight into the BKB, not the item pickup I would have imagined Chaos Knight wants to go for. Normally you see Armlet, Mantas, Hearts of Tarrasque, but once the magic community.
Oh, he gets rooted. Oh, nice play there.
The root the frostbite. That cancels the waveform out.
That's not a huge pickup, but the CK, that combination certainly is. And, well, another stun comes in, but you've got the Slark right there on top of Y. He is going to end up dropping. So Mind Control able to escape while they take down the Skywrath Mage again.
Now the Blink stun.
Oh, nice pickup there. Able to find the kill. Dodges the pounce as well. Nicely played by Faith Beyond.
Whoops, got the retreat. Next Shadow Blade. We could see Miracle look to re-engage.
All right, they're going in again. Why not? Just keep on battling. It's been a battle throughout the mid lane, starting at the Radiant Tier 2, basically.
Constant brawling. This is the Wings Chaos. And Liquid hitting them head-on, which works pretty well for a Slark with a Shadow Blade Echo Saber. He's ready to fight. He's ready to take these engagements, but does need to be a little bit careful, since some of his teammates maybe not quite so ready. The Aegis has expired on Matu. Managed to just pick up the next item or two where they got up to the Dragonlance with the Maelstrom now. And it looks like his next pickup is going to be a BKB for himself. It does feel like this Wings draft will be on a bit of a timer when perhaps Chaos Knight gets like a level 3 ultimate like to kind of end the game. I don't think they'll want it to drag too much beyond that. Lone Druid, for the most part, has seemed to be the better of the two snipers as far as the game scaling into the late game, so see if that's going to continue to be the case. Imagine they'll try and use this sniper plus level 3 CK Phantasm to try and siege high ground.
Oh, this is a really nice play. They go on the Skywrath with the Slark, and then they're able to find, well, maybe not. Slark in a little bit of trouble. It's going to be forced back away. They were able to take down Shadow regardless. The ulti from the CM on the low ground, and so the final result is 2 dead for Wings, but they do get the Slark, and well, Faith Beyond Burrow Strike. They come back in with the Shadow trying to take down Earl. They are going to pop the ulti there, and they find the kill. Now turning on to that Centaur as well. He drops. So they take down 3.
What a response from Wings again. They're just always ready to fight into it. Faith Beyond is really good at timing his Burrow Strike, such as they catch the Slark after Dark Pact. Miracle knows it's coming. Like, every time he's going in for these pickoffs, he's immediately using Shadow Dance after Dark Pact so he doesn't get silenced or something by Skywrath. But Zankin just burrows him through the Shadow Dance, and constantly it's been plaguing him. This time was one of the first where he actually did get silenced for the Shadow Dance. And as a result, he goes down. Not really worth it at this point to trade his life for the snipers, considering he's the much more farmed of the two carries. The Chaos Knight is the one you've got to worry about, and Shadow, who got the kills in response. A double kill for him gets him up to 11.3k net worth. He is the most farmed here in the game.
Another pickoff over there as well. Good use of the Savage Roar to make sure that the Morphling wasn't able to waveform out and away and didn't even necessarily need the root. But there's another BKB picked up, this time on the Lone Druid. So 14-14, we're 22 minutes into this game, and it's feeling like it's just all-out brawling. Is there a team that you feel like this favors more than the other?
Wings for sure, for now at least, as long as they can maintain their farm while they brawl. And that's what the Midas has done for Chaos Knight. It means that throughout all this constant fighting, he's still getting some decent income.
Oh, they're going in again over here, trying to TP out, but not going to happen. And, well, that is going to be another sniper kill.
That's the one here that doesn't really want to brawl. Sniper is a bit behind on farm. He's going to go as fast as possible into this Hurricane Pike, so he has that defensive force to try and save his life in some of these situations. But Sniper has definitely been the one here who has not enjoyed this constant fighting on the wing side. Problem is, if your team's fighting like as a four-man unit and you're a sniper, you can't really go up and split switch a lane or farm by yourself because you're such easy prey for a Slark, a Centaur, as we just saw. There's so many heroes that can just kill you if you're alone. So Sniper almost has to stick with his team, and that's just been a bit too much fighting for the Sniper himself. Even if, like, the Sand King, the Wolf, all the other four heroes are happy to fight, just not the Sniper.
Nice Courier pick there as well. Able to take that one, Miracle.
They've perhaps got ice if he's not careful.
Oh, Crutton. Yeah, pump fake, but still ends up throwing it out. Gonna switch now over to Strength. Waveforms out, and
really,
that was really close. He's, okay, Shadow pops. BKB wants to fight, turns now, but there's gonna be a Shadow Dance to back out. And Burst Strike connects after the Dark Pack, and Reality Earth, barely off the mark. Does look like Liquid's gonna get out. Did my eyes deceive myself for a second? Is Morphling going for an Agonist?
Yeah, he's going for an Axe. Wants to make, oops, I don't know, is he making CK illusions so far? Other illusions? Like, what are the big spells here that he wants to be able to make, take advantage of? You get a secondary Silence from Skyrath. You don't get those
Burrow
ultimates.
Strike, maybe?
Burrow Strike, not bad. I mean, so far I've been seeing a lot of CK replicates, but as far as hybrids go, who do you want to hybrid? I mean, CK's stun is pretty nice. Shrapnel. I wonder how many shrapnels you get. If you get triple shrapnel when you make a sniper hybrid, I would say that sounds pretty damn nice, but
no. It's definitely a very different build, one that we don't always see. If you take Skyrath, or his silence, will that double up the amount of amplified damage you take?
That's
something. I mean, this is one of those that
you gotta.
Yeah.
You could ask, like, Tsunami or something. You need a new co-caster for that one. I'm sorry. I'll have to substitute myself out temporarily.
We'll say if that works, then that might be a thing that they go for.
My speculation would be no. Like, it would just replace the old one. Like, when you recast it, it would just reset the cooldown on the old one. Like, it doesn't strike me as something that would stack with itself, but who knows?
Wings, no.
Yeah,
sure.
Probably. Wings are definitely based on, like, that Invoker, Brewmaster, start. We say they're a team that knows these funky mechanics and tries to take advantage of them.
Oh, GH looking for the initiation. Finds two. Skyrath left alone for the moment. They're going to be able to take him down very quickly. A second one comes down as well. Shadow is out of there. And amp damage on Sniper. They'll have eyes on him. Great little smoke gank there for side of Team Liquid.
I mean, that's a kill that will secure your racks and give you a massive advantage. Up until this point, it felt like things were pretty even. Wings were, like, being the aggressors, but never really getting the best trades because Miracle was able to always find kills in return. And, like, Sniper Illusion is going to try to bait out some spells here, but just an illusion is this Sniper.
Now there's the Burrow Strike, then the Adaptive Strike follow. Still hitting away onto this tower, not wanting to commit too much. And man, Tumbleman dropped very low there.
We see a retreat, shrine up, even just full-on heal up. They don't really want to just throw away an Aegis at this point. If they can go for another push with it, fantastic. And CK is about to respawn. So they get some damage on a tier 3 while CK's down. I think the most farm wings hero definitely working out well for them. Just wasn't quite at that Manta style, and does feel like Wing's going to hit like a level 18 CK with Manta style, and at that point they need to make something happen. I don't think their lineup is going to be able to keep up beyond that. Like, CK can still continue to farm all right with the Midas, but you've got three good farming heroes on the Radiant side, Slark, Lone Druid, and Centaur. Centaur with Return can match up pretty well against that. Chaos Knight can even go to like a Crimson Guard if he wants. Later on, like level 25, you get the Return Aura, so the right-click damage of the Chaos Knight can be turned around upon him, as well as the Sniper later on, so very good hero to have against some of these right clickers as this game drags.
Well, 17-14 again, and it's getting towards that point in time. I'm kind of wondering as well if you can go just for another smoke gank immediately. Like, Liquid still have the Aegis. They're at full HP at this point.
Looks like they want to.
Definitely could be the play.
Got three heroes grouped up around mid with a smoke, but Matu, I think, saying, look, we need to push up this top lane first. It's going to be too obvious if we just smoke up before doing this.
There's the Manta style now for the CK.
Okay.
So amping up this damage even further. A little bit interesting to see, like you were talking about earlier, the BKB first. Might end up hampering him as the game goes on.
It's down to 7 seconds already. It just felt like a game where you didn't desperately need a BKB. Like, you're looking at CM Frostbite, Center Sun, and he was very, like, trigger-happy with using that BKB. Like, we saw him preemptively BKB at the bottom tier 2 tower when he tried to catch the Slack. Was very close to doing so, but still seemed a bit odd. Nice blink dodge from GA. Definitely something you're going to have to be quick with the blink daggers against this Morphling. Dodging adaptive strikes is going to be a very important thing to do. Otherwise, you could get first down very, very quickly.
Dropping a couple wards. Ice Ice just going to head off through the jungle, pick up a bounty rune, head on his merry little way. And we're seeing the heart queued up right now as well for CK. It feels like this item build has basically never changed for CK.
Nope. I mean, the order he got the items was different this game, which is what I don't really like. I think the Manta first could have been good. It would have got you out of the Corrosive Haze early on, as well as the Frostbite. But BKB similarly also does that. It's just like you want to try and save BKB for later in the game, make use of that 10-second one. But right now, Sniper finally gets his Hurricane Pike. He is kind of dirt poor. He has really struggled this game. Very low level, only level 14 as well, so Blinker's been constantly in catch-up mode. And he does all right damage, but a lot more of his damage is going to come from stuff like the Shrapnel and the Assassinate, really, with how far he's fallen behind. At least he does have good stun setup to get damage value out of those spells.
Definitely. And Lone Druid sitting top of the net worth mark at this point. He has been a real monster. Slark also going back for the Scotty after finishing off the BKB using the Echo Saber.
It's such a good BKB game for Liquid. Like, this is that's where Liquid are going to hit their peak, and where I definitely favor them at this point and moving forward, because BKBs on their two carries. Matu hasn't even used his. So he got his some time ago, but he's still sitting on the 10-second BKB for a high ground siege or just the next teamfight. Counters so much of the damage of Wings.
They're set up out there in the mid lane. They might decide to go into Shadow, but there are so many heroes up on the high ramp, ready for the counter initiation. They managed to get the Pearl Strike in the midst of it. They are going to be able to take down Shadow. Faithion not able to save him in time. There's too much damage.
He just melted. That was too fast to do anything in return, and they'll go to bottom, take the T2, and probably even threaten the high ground, thinking, okay, this CK might have a buyback. Let's try and force him. What they will find is that he does not have a buyback. Likely going to see some damage onto a tier 3 tower here with Aegis still in. Okay, Aegis expires, so that could give Liquid some second thoughts about this.
And that's one of those moments where you think about one of the other supports that you might have been able to take, one of those defensive ones possibly, you know, a Dazzle there or something for a Grave at the last second. And you don't have that afforded to you. I feel like you need to be aggressive with this Wings draft in a certain way.
Yeah, Wings seem all in on the aggression and control. Lots of damage output, lots of control, but not much in the way of save and defensive capabilities.
Yeah. So thinking about the next couple of minutes and the way that this goes, of course, we're going to be eventually getting that Aghanim Scepter up and online for the Morphling, as well as just more items. But I'm sort of wondering if, like, it feels like Wings almost need just the perfect team fight to even be able to stand up against Liquid. And even then, it's nothing is guaranteed, really.
Yeah, they're probably thinking, like, we just want to defend high ground. But if you're Liquid, you're like, well, let's stop them out. Let's accept the fact that we may not be able to break high ground anytime soon, at least not without an Aegis. So you're probably going to wait for some of those big PI decisions, like the Aegis and a couple of
Another four staff. They still got the right clicks, trying to stampede out in a way. The Assassinate is there as well, but it looks like he'll be able to escape. Scary moment there for him.
With some of those spells used, will Liquid want to press forward? Probably not. They use Stampede. If anything, that was the bigger of the ultimates. But they are grouped around this mid lane, perhaps hoping for some kind of good initiation.
Now Burrow, they push him back yet again. Miracle ends up getting stunned. They're going to be able to get him. There's a really long duration, and, well, is going to be silence to follow. Pops the BKB, turns the fight. Shadow taking a lot of damage. Pops the ulti as well. Oh, looks like that's going to just be enough to get him out and away.
2-minute cooldown, so not what you want to see out of your Phantasm. And Liquid, I think, smelling blood, are ready to push forward. Even without an Aegis, they know this is a big timing for them to go for. They've got the Lincolns on top of the BKB on Matu's Lone Druid, so two defensive items there, as well as that level 20 talent with the minus 40 respawn time. So he's a very safe hero to have seizing that high ground with, and he'll chip away at it with that extra long range.
Yeah, it's really frustrating to deal with, and the Lincoln Sphere being really effective, obviously, against that long-duration stun that we see from the Morphling.
He still hasn't got his axe. He's been working it for quite some time, had two pieces for a long time, and he's still 500 gold short, so... Yeah, still no hybrid.
You just talk about it. It's that starvation that we were mentioning. They haven't been able to farm almost at all. So Matumba Man keeps on hitting away at this tier 3 tower. There's no way to stop it. They pull back in Miracle, get the 2 second stun, but all of these four staffs, everything, keeping Liquid alive, there's just no answer at all. And, well, maybe they can get him, but Miracle just pops the Shadow Dance to back out and away. Well, another Burrow Strike, Mystic Flare off the mark as well. The four staffs are just tremendous. Look at this. What's going on? They get one kill finally. This will come in handy. Yeah, that's absurd.
Okay. That was some impressive defensive four-star use, but it is still Wings who defend high ground, and it does definitely go back to the fact that pushing high ground against this Wings lineup is going to be a pain in the ass. Sniper, one of the best. He's got an Axe Sanking. Morphling's pretty damn good just because he sits there throwing adaptive strikes at any hero. Even just a Spirit Bear on the high ground, he'll just stun it, and then his team will just throw spells at it, right-click it down. So very annoying and frustrating to push against this Wings team.
And sort of mentioning again that fact that this is a team that's used to taking their time and making sure that they don't make the wrong overstep. They don't overplay their hand necessarily. And we're seeing that here. It feels to me as if they're going to be comfortable continuing to farm away. But is there a point where Wings sort of hits a secondary timing that overtakes what Liquid has?
They've gone for a BKB on Sniper, which is like a defensive item and an item which kind of... Again, when you get that BKB, you're very strong with that first neutral too. That's when it's 10 seconds. So to me, this is like Wings saying, we want to be strong now. They're not necessarily going to scale well. This is not going to help Sniper farm. His next time is going to be very slow. He's only going to get to like a next big item through getting kills and actually winning team fights. So without winning fights now, Wings are not going to get to those next big items. They are really hoping that they can take a good smoke out, probably contest Roshan. This is the third Rosh, so Aegis and Cheese. They don't want to let Liquid just secure another Aegis and Cheese, because that next fight gets very difficult if those items are picked up. So, sure enough, Wings group up as five, they smoke out, and they're going to be looking to get some aggressive wards up, take a fight, stop Liquid from getting that next Rosh.
This is a hybrid
Skywrath,
as well.
You do not want to stand in front, Skywrath Mage. That is not how you want your smoke to be popped.
That's poor, actually really rough.
Poor positioning from Mr. Y there, but wasn't expecting the smoke to perhaps pop and reveal so early, and that means that smoke was effectively wasted. They immediately all back off, and I mean Liquid on the other side smoking up themselves. More important than perhaps fighting is going to be securing this Rosh, so they actually just go straight into the pit.
Wow, that was just tragic for Wings. Like, you invest all of this timing into it. You get your BKB on Sniper. The Aghanim's is done now on Morphling, and only to have it pop right down the Skywrath Mage in the mid lane. You get a Stampede out there trying to find the kill onto that Skywrath Mage up in the top lane, but it looks like it's just going to be the Aegis taken. But the Tombo Man picks it up, and off to the races again.
We'll be back to sieging soon enough. Like what Machu's doing, just going very safe defensive. Lincoln, BKB, into a Scotty. He's going for serious survivability. Even though he's the sieging, damage dealing hero, Lone Druid, you just do enough damage as is. So what you need to do is stay alive, and exactly what this item build of his will do.
Bro, adaptive strike there as well. Waveform's out, trying to get out in a way. They have already popped the BKB ulti as well. They're able to take down one. Pearl, already dead. Now looking for more. Miracle on top of that. Morphling is going to be able to take him down, and there's the Mystic Flare as well. They find the kill under mind control as well as Y, and the Epicenter doing a good bit, but it's just 2-for-2 at this point. Matumba Man pops his BKB. Aegis intact, and looks like Liquid end up coming out head on that.
Yeah, right now it looks like Wings are holding their own, but still not getting big enough trades. They're going to lose their shrines off of that. They're going to... No.
Well, and now Miracle again. He's heading off towards the jungle. You look at this, Butterfly completed at this point. I don't believe that we're close to having an MKB online at this stage for Wings. It feels like it's sort of, they don't have the items to really deal with it, nor the heroes. It's a rough game right now.
Yeah, It is, and they're like all in on this BKB commitment, so they've got the ability to, like, for Sniper to at least guarantee get some damage output out, but Slark is elusive. We've seen what the Force Staffs can do as far as pushing people around. So locking. In control, they've got not an easy task necessarily, but they will continue to probably try and test the Liquid high ground team, which has yet to take a lane of Rack. So, I mean, you're still going to wonder, like, what's it going to take? Liquid haven't been able to break through just yet.
Yeah. They're cool. They're just testing an illusion as well. I feel like they just can go wherever they want at this point on the map with Impunity. Like, there's nothing that Wings can really do to lock them down if Liquid play this correctly. And, well, another Burrow Strike.
It's
going to connect there onto the CM, and, well, if you're shooting on back at him, the Insta game is assassinated himself. They are going to be able to take down right off the bat that CK, or SK rather, and he's eaten as well. Mind Control going to survive through it. Very well played by Liquid. Shadow in trouble. Amp damage there. GH is going to be able to crush. They find the kill. Miracle picks it up. And Liquid well on the way to finishing this one off here.
Yeah, that might be just the pickoff they needed to break through this high ground.
Now, I mean, Yule's Scepter is up there online as well. The Tier 3 tower going to start to fall, and it looks like with the Mjolnir procs hitting away there onto the Sniper, and they're still playing this so safe. That's the thing that's crazy to me.
Like, they don't know the CK's buyback status. Don't believe there or where they did probably see the Reva pickup, which is a big sign. Like, he picked up a Reva on the way to a heart, and he likely doesn't have a fed. They still can't get around.
Follow up Mind Control. They're on top of the Silence. Nowhere to go. Is going to fall.
Stun on Miracle.
Well, maybe.
Go with a butterfly.
They just don't have any damage, and there's no answer at all. And with another one going down here, buybacks come out from the Sniper. Maybe, just maybe, they can make something from this. Matumbo Man's going to get hit with the Epicenter. He doesn't give a damn. Mystic Flare comes down as well. There is just no mercy at all at this point for Wings.
They're diving for kills. CK is going to finally respawn, but he's going to be finding two of his teammates dead. So he's not really got any good way to engage or fight. He's going to TP right in and try and see what he can do, but...
Well, there's the BKB, turns the fight, maybe something, but the right clicks are coming through. Miracle about to be on top of him as well. And Skyrim's Mage, there's the lift up. GH is not going to go down there. Matumbo Man, Aegis is going to proc, and, well, they chase down Shadow. He ends up dying. Never give up, never surrender, but there's nothing else to fight for here.
Yeah, well closed out game by Liquid. Wings were just so gung-ho, they were so keen to stick to their guns. You can't really blame them. That was, like, the nature of their draft they wanted. It cost him in the end, like the CK dying outside of his base without buy. We saw it a few times, but they were able to hold without him. That time at the end, later